Hello everyone, it's Naima Afreen, your math teacher, welcome you all again in our math online class. How are you all? I hope all of you are safe and sound and you are staying at home in this pandemic situation. So my dear students, let's move on our today's topic. But before going to start our today's lesson, I want to ask you about our previous lesson. So what was our previous lesson? Yes, you know that we have started a chapter problem related to addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. And already we have done so many problems from this chapter. And today I will show you two problems from this chapter. So everybody take out your CD of the copy, book, diary in front of you. And before going to start our class, can I ask you some question from our previous lesson? Yes. Students, you know, from this chapter name, problem related to addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. In this chapter, we have discussed four method like addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. And by reading out the question, sometimes we have done addition and sometimes we have done subtraction, sometimes we have done multiplication or division here, and both method we have apply here, isn't it? Yes, this is the combination of four method. This chapter is the combination of four methods. Whatever we have learned in addition chapter, subtraction chapter, multiplication or division chapter. So this is the combination of four methods. Okay. So can you tell me there what is the clue word of division? Can you remember? Yes, very good. The clue word of division is, we know that distribute, divide, equally, share. Okay, so this is the clue word of division, remaining also. Okay, now look at the board. I am giving a question here for you. There are five books in each almirah. So how many books are there in 6 almirah? So what should we do now to find out the answer? Which method I have to apply here? Yes, very good. Here we have to do the multiplication. Okay, today I will show you two problems from page 72. At first I will show you problem number 9. So look at the question. I have written the question here, and you know that in what problem always we have to read out the question very attentively. Okay, so look at the question. I have written the question. Rahim's weight is 25 kg. Akash's weight is 3 kg more than Rahim's weight. And Ali's weight is 34 kg. What is the difference between Akash and Ali's weight? So dear students, you know before that what problem they have given you some information part, and they have asked you a question, there is asking part. Okay, so there they give you the information. Look at the question. That they have given Rahim's weight 25 kg. Okay, we know it very well. Directly they have told you that Rahim's weight is 25 kg. But look at the second line. They have told you Akash's weight is 3 kg more than Rahim's weight. They did not tell you here the Akash's weight directly. They told you that Akash's weight is 3 kg more than Rahim's weight. Okay. And Alice weight, they have already given you directly that Alice weight is how many kg? 34 kg. And look, what is the asking part for you? They have asked you what is the difference between Akash and Alice weight. But at first, what should I do here in that problem? They want to know the difference between Akash and Alice weight. But here they didn't tell you Akash weight directly. So how can I find out the difference between Ali and Akash weight? So what should I do here? Yes, at first I have to find out Akash weight. What is the weight of Akash? So they have given you the information. How can I find out the Akash weight? Because they told you that Akash weight is 3 kg more than Rohim's weight. So let's start the solution. At first, we have to find out Akash weight. So how can I find out Akash weight? They have given you some clue here for you that 3 kg more than. This is the clue word for you. 3 kg more than. So how can I find out? Look at the board. I am writing the solution. At first, I can write here solution. Everybody start writing. I have to write Rohim's weight is, we know it, Rohim's weight is 25 kg. Okay. And they have given you the information that Akash weight is 3 kg more than Rohim. Akash weight is 3 kg more than, we have to write this information here so that everybody can understand Rohim's. Okay, Rohim's weight. We have to write this information so that everybody can understand about this information. So now I will find out Akash weight at first. So Akash we have to do here what, which method? Can you guess? We have to use here addition, because they have to give you the information that Akash weight is 3 kg more than Rohim's weight. So Rohim's weight is 25 kg, we know. So if we increase the number 3 kg, then we can get the Akash weight. So how can I increase the number? We have to do here the subtraction. No, we have to do here addition, because they have told you 3 kg more than Rohim's weight. So Rohim's weight we know, 25 kg. So Akash weight is, we have to do here the addition, 25 plus 3, okay, kg. So have you understood that what, why I have done here the addition? Because they have given me the information that Akash weight is 3 kg more than Rohim's weight. So already we know Rohim's weight. So we have to increase the number. Yeah. So 25 plus 3. And when, oh, we know that whenever we have to increase the number, we have to do here the addition that time. So 25 plus 3. It will be what here? 25 plus 3. Use your finger line. It is very easy. 25, 26, 27, 28. So it will be 28 kg. Got the answer here that Akash weight is 28 kg. It is our final answer. No, we just here find out the weight of Akash. Now they have asked you the last question, that is, what is the difference between Akash and Ali's weight? It is very easy to find out now the difference between Akash and Ali's weight. And difference, what is the, in which method we have to use this word difference? What should we do here? if they are asking you about difference, yes, we have to do here the subtraction to find out the difference between Ali and Akash Bey. So I am doing here the subtraction now. Now I am writing that Ali's weight is 34 kg, and Akash, I have to write now, got Akash weight. Akash weight is 28 kg. So we have to do here the subtraction. That's why I am giving here the subtraction sign. Okay. Now we have to do here the subtraction, and we have to find out the difference between Akash and Ali's weight. So I am writing here difference. Difference is, so do the subtraction here. Look, this is the smaller number, 4. So we have to borrow 1 10 from the tens list. You know the system of doing the subtraction. So I can take here 10 from the tens place. These 3 will give 1 10 to the ones place. So these 3 will become now what? I have to cut these 3. These 3 10 will become now 2. So it will become now 2, and ones place will get 10. So now do the subtraction. 10 plus 4, it will be 40, and 40 minus 8. What will be the answer? 40 minus 8, use your finger line. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Yes. So I got here 6. Okay. So go to the next tens place. Take 2 minus 2. So 2 minus 2, what will be there? There will be nothing. Yes, so I got your answer 6 kg. Okay, students. So this is our answer 6 kg. Now, at last, students, look, I have written the answer that the difference between Akash and Ali's weight is 6 kg. So all of you, I hope all of you have understood this problem number 9. Okay, so let's move for the next problem. I am showing you problem number 10. So look at the board. I have written the question here. It is possible to keep 42 books in a cell, and 2 such cells are filled with books, and there are 8 more books. How many books are there all together? So students, I told you before that we have to read the question properly, that they have given you some information, and by using this information we can find out our answer. But look, at last they have asked you how many books are there all together. So all together means what? All together is the clue word of which method? It is the clue word of addition method. So at last we have to do here their addition, that how many books are there all together. But at first, what should I do? What things I have to find out? Here they have given you the information that in one cell I can keep 42 books, and like this cell we can keep also 42 books. So there are how many cells? 2 cells, and in these 2 cells we can keep the same number of books. So at first, what should I do? At first I have to find out in these 2 cells how many books I can keep. Okay, this thing we have to find out at first, otherwise we cannot find out the total number of books. As we know before that one self I can to keep 42 books. So in two selves, easily we can find out that how many books I can keep there. How can I find out that how in two selves how many books I can get? Which method I can apply here? Yes, I can apply here multiplication, because we know that whenever we find out the total number of things, then we have to do the multiplication. And they have given you there here the one self I can keep 42 books. So more than one self, how can I find out? By doing the multiplication. Easily we can find out. Okay, we can also do here the addition, but multiplication is easiest process than addition. It will save our time. So I am writing here solution. At first I have to find out that in two self how many book I can find keep. So these things is the first we have to find out. So I can write here in one self there are 42 books. As we know this information, so easily I can find out in two cells there are 42 multiplied by 2, because we are finding out now at first the total number of books that we can keep in two cells. Okay, at first we have to find out. So do here the multiplication. I can show here the rough form. Look at the rough form. 42 multiplied by 2. So I am showing the rough form here. 42 multiplied by 2. So look at there. 2 twos are what? 2 twos are 4. Now 2 fours are 8. So I got here 84 books. Yes, I can keep 84 books in 2 cells. Okay. So I got here the answer 84 books. But it is not our final answer. They have given me another information here that after keeping in two cells, some books are extra here. I cannot keep this book in the cells. Okay. So this is the number 8. They have given you the information. There are more 8 books. So, what should I do now? Here, with these 84 books, and I have now 8 more books extra. And they are asking you that how many books are there all together. So, if I write these things only 80, that in two cells, there are 84 books. It will be correct. No, with these 84 books, I have to add these 8 number of books also. Then I can get the total number of books. Because they are giving you the information that there are more 8 books also there. So what should I do now? I can write like this way. This is our rough work, and I can write like this way. There are 8 more books. This information I have to write it here. There are 8 more books. So these books I have to do what? I have to add with these 84 numbers to find out the total number of books. The all together how many books are there. So all together I have to do here the addition. 84 plus 8. These 8 books I cannot keep in this 2 cell. Okay. So that's why at first I have find out in 2 self, how many books I can keep? So by doing the multiplication at first, I have found that there I can keep 84 books. But they have again give you the information that 8 more books are there. So I have to do here the now addition to find out the total number all together, how many books are there. So all together 84 plus 8 books. So do the addition here. You can show the rough work here. That will be 84 plus 8. So I can do here the addition. 8 plus 4, what will be there? Use your finger line. 8 plus 4, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So 12 and 2 I can write here and 1 I am carrying. Now 8 plus 1, it will be 92. Now I got the answer that they are all together 92 books. Have you understood, students? That why I am doing here the addition? Because they have given you the information that after keeping the cells, 8 more books are there. Okay, so that's why. How can I find the total number? With these 84 numbers, I have to add these 8 books also. Okay. Then I got the answer 92 books altogether there. Now students, at last I have to write the answer. The answer is 92 books are there altogether. So everybody write this problem properly in your copy. Okay. I hope that all of you have understood these two problems, that is problem number 9 and problem number 10 properly. Okay. Now students, you know that already we have done all the work problem from page 72. And in this chapter, sometimes we use addition, sometimes we use subtraction, multiplication, division. So this is the combination of 4 methods. So if I ask you that what is the clue word of subtraction, can you tell me? Yes, the clue word of subtraction is difference, let, remain, then more than, less than. Then we have to do the subtraction here. So look at the word. I am giving you a question for you. Can you tell me that which method we have to apply here to find out the answer? Just tell me the which method we have to apply in it, what problem. So look at the board. There are 44 students in a class. How many benches will be needed for 4 students to sit in each bench? So which method we have to find out the answer? We have to find out here the benches. Okay, so which method we have to apply here? Yes, very good. This is the word problem of division. Okay, I think that you have practiced more at your home for this chapter. Okay, so now students, it's time for giving your homework. So your homework is, take out your diary and write down, practice all word problem from page 72. Okay. So write down the homework and practice more and more at home. And think properly that which method we have to apply to solve the problem. So students, no more today. See you in my next class. So till then, Allah Hafiz. And bye-bye.